Dr. Jack Kevorkian, a pathologist, says he is doing this to correct what he calls medical ethics, allowing a terminally ill patient to choose, not doctors or lawyers, whether to live or die.
I want this to be a medical service that's controlled. It isn't now. It's all hit or miss. Lay people are shooting each other and suffocating each other and poisoning each other, and drowning each other. That's silly. How can doctors stand by and watch that?
That's why Dr. Kevorkian came up with this device. After more than two decades as a pathologist, he saw a need to fill a very difficult void. Here's how it works. The doctor injects a needle into the patient and starts the flow of the first bottle with a simple saline solution in it.
Then the patient reaches over and just touches that switch once, maybe twice. I'll have him do it twice to make sure. And that cuts off, the mechanism in the machine cuts off this saline inside and turns this one on, which is pentothal.
That'll put a patient into a coma, which then automatically starts the third solution,
in which is concentrated potassium chloride, and this stops the heart as soon as it reaches it. So he has a heart attack in deep coma, which is like dying in your sleep.
David Rivlin, the paralyzed Farmington Hills man, one of three Oakland County people to win the right to be taken off life support and die, had favored Dr. Kevorkian's method.
Yeah, I was going to do it at that time, carbon monoxide.
See? Oh, were you? For Rivlin?
Yeah, and I didn't think it would be hard to. I was going to set up a thing where he could switch on the canister of gas, see? Yeah. Which is nice. There's no odor, taste, or anything, carbon monoxide. But it was clumsy. But when I came forward, then his own doctor said, okay, I'll pull the plug.
Dr. Kevorkian's device, which would take less than 4 minutes to end a life, has not yet faced the legal test. The state attorney general's office says neither lawmakers or the courts have adequately addressed the issue.
And this is an immoral law to stop this, you see. So I will disobey it. Then they can go, if I'm a criminal, then, you can look at me and say, you're a criminal, then throw me in jail. But keep me there, because if I get out, I'll do it again.
Dr. Kevorkian also cites a panel of doctors from the Society for the Right to Die, quoted in the New England Journal of Medicine, as saying, quote, physicians who help terminally ill patients commit suicide by prescribing drugs and counseling about lethal dosages are acting ethically.
Dana? This way, with his machine, only the person who dies would bear responsibility for their death.
That's exactly right. They push the button.
Changes in the law, though, would be necessary.
Michigan doesn't have anything right now. Lawmakers still debating and have been for months and months. There are three states, Oregon, California, and Washington State, which by 1990 may put it on the ballot, but that's still a may.